Greetings, you malt maverick machines and milk balls. That's Brandon's malt mention. So there you have it, Brandon. Your malt mention just got malt mentioned. And thank you very much indeed. And welcome one and all to Whisky Review 237 here at Ralphie.com, home of the slightly dysfunctional, eccentric and individual whisky reviews. Splendid. So what are we reviewing today, I hear you asking? Oh yes, I do. Get on with it, Ralphie. Okay, little story for you. During the summer, when my biker friends were visiting, they had a bit of a problem. What do you get the whisky commentator who has quite a lot of whiskies? Well, you've got to get something a little bit different. And Jiffy and Margaret, my biker buddies, well, they hit the jackpot when they brought me this double miniature presentation box. Here it is. And it contains two lesser well-known blended whiskies. Here they are. I'll hold these little miniature bottles up closely so you can get a good swatch, which is a good Scottish word, swatch. It means observation. Oh. Well, that's one glass down. But the bottle's still intact. That's what matters. This is the pig's nose. And this one is the sheep dip. Moving on. And both of them blended whiskies, which you will see on the shelves of shops, and you'll be wondering to yourself, that's a silly name, you know, does it mean it's a silly whiskey? Well, they're actually both quite decent whiskies, so I'm going to review them for you and tell you a little bit about them. We'll start with Pig's Nose. This is a small independent bottling company who employed the services of Richard Patterson, the Dr. Barnum of whisky blenders, and a very successful ambassador for Scotch whisky around the world. My goodness, I don't think White and Mackay would be quite the same without Richard. He does a lot of good work for them. And He's blended together for the small independent whisky bottler two blends. The pig's nose, representing, of course, I don't know if you've had much contact with pigs, but pig's noses tend to be wet, soft, velvety and inquisitive. And so they wanted a whisky like that. It's a five-year-old blended whisky, blended Scotch. Now, that means it's got grain whisky in it. And they didn't stop there. They also bottled a blend of single malts. Now, there's ever so many blends. I think about 15 or so malts involved in sheep dip. And the story behind sheep dip is that if you go down to the farm, you will find that farmers are using a powerful pesticide called sheep dip, which they dip the sheep in prior to shearing, and it kills off all the little insects and ticks and stuff that tend to lodge themselves in sheep's wool. And it's well known that the farmers in particular are not wishing to pay tax, some folk are like that, on their whiskies. In the old days, what they'd do is they'd get their whisky supply delivered up to the farm in a container marked sheep dip, so as it didn't get subject to tax. There we go. That's the story, that's the legend, and who am I to argue. Right, I've gone and put that sheep's dip back without pouring a glass. This was quite a nice actual tumbler, but I won't be able to use it anymore because I've now chipped the top of it as I dropped that miniature bottle on it. You know, shit happens. We've got to get on, got to move on, got to get over it. Pig's nose. Ooh, lovely. Bottled at 40%, 5-year-old whiskey. That's young. With young whiskey, you should be expecting some roughness. However, with pig's nose, that really isn't the case. For a relatively young blended scotch, it's got quite a lot of class to it. My notes go as such: young but relatively smooth. Honey, smoky malt, grain-rich vanilla, some sawdust in a nice way, some Isla salt breeze, soft corn grain. Apparently it's Invergordon grain that's used. And there's a certain hay and grassiness on the nose as well. When adding water to this, I would recommend that you add no more than a drop. Otherwise, it starts to kind of lose its quality. Taste. Fresh, sweet arrival with some wood bitters in it, balancing it off quite early on, toning down that sweetness, some light sherry notes, and some intrinsic complexity for what is a young scotch. Surprisingly delicate, hints of kulila, crisp, light, woodsap, apple, soft spice, allspice, and a touch of smoke. The finish disappears into a nice, mild English breakfast tea with a spot of honey. Lovely. A quality young blend with very little poor cask involvement. You know, generally you can see that there's been first fill bourbon casks in particular used in this blend quite successfully. It's not been padded out too much, and I suspect that there's two reasons for that. Because the producers, the bottlers anyway, who are the SpencerfieldSpirit.com, that's where you want to go if you want to find the website. And because there's not a great demand for this, and because they've been around for a while, they know that their established customers, they're looking for that continuity of character, and I think it's there, and it remains there and has remained there for quite a while, because I've tasted this a few times over the years and I've never tasted a bad one yet. Excellent. So I'm going to give this a very nice 86 out of 100 for the pig's nose. There we are. Shuffle these glasses around a little bit. Moving on to the sheep dip. Same company, Spencerfield Spirit, but a different whiskey completely. This is a blend of malts. There's no grain whiskey involved in sheep dip. And my notes go as such. Again, bottled at 40%. I can confirm it's a blend of 16 different malts. On the nose, fresh wood and a hint of sherry. Mild, delicate sherry. Malty, chocolatey. Some Isla, rice wine, raisin, cocoa, mace, nutmeg. Some toffee comes through, particularly when you add a drop of water, sultana, and fig. Again, like the pig's nose, I recommend just a drop or two of water just to open up this blended malt Again, the malts involved are a little bit older. This is a kind of step up from pig's nose. The sheep dip is, I think, intended to be more of a premium product. There's a nose coming off this which many single malts would be pleased to have. Taste-wise, articulate. What do I mean by articulate? I mean that the malts which have been involved in this, they've really come together and blended and meshed together very well. There's no particular single malt standing out here. I do notice a touch of, I think, Jura, Feta, Cairn and Kulila. Well, I think it's Kulila. That's the impression I get amongst these single malts. But there is 16 in all, so it's kind of rather hard to pick them about. So I'm not going to waste any more time trying. It's fresh sherry honey. Slightly smoky, certainly slightly peaty, and again you've got that little sherriness going on. Honey, damp hay, and with water, there is a lovely sweetness and fresh fruit note comes through with soft Isla sea salty little bits in it. The finish is, after a time, I've noticed lavender creeps into the finish. But it doesn't really do any harm at all, because the lavender's quite quality. It's not something that kind of smothers the other tastes involved in this blended malt. So I'm going to give this 88 out of 100. And that is a malt blend mark for the sheep dip. And a blend mark for the pig's nose. Now, you may be interested to know, my fellow maltsters, that there is a sort of deluxe version of the sheep dip, which I'll be reviewing next year. As you can see, I bought it because it was the only bottle left in the shop. I bought this little 20 centilitre bottle. Which is very handy, by the way. When you finish drinking the whiskey, you keep the bottle and you decant your expensive old sherried numbers that's cost you a small fortune. You know, and you don't want it oxidising in the bottle as the level goes down. So here's a handy little bottle that you can decant these old whiskies into. This is Sheep Dip Old Hebridean. It is a blend of three single malts. I won't tell you any more than that. But it's this one, as you can see, the price tag $16.95. So for this small bottle is the cost of a standard blend. So it has to be good for that price. But I'm pleased to say it's quite a successful marrying of three old single malts. And I'll tell you more about that when I review it next year. But it does exist. It is out there. And if you see it, well, it's Ralphie recommended. Oh, yes, indeedy. Lovely. I conclude by saying, when you see a whiskey with a silly name or something that's being not too serious, don't write it off or dismiss it as being less of a decent whiskey. It may simply not be the case. That there are some whiskies with silly names which aren't that good, but there are also some which are brilliant. And furthermore, as time's going on, as whisky scene is evolving internationally, it's safe to say that there are some whiskies out there with very serious and respectable names which are simply not what they were and really not quite what they should be. But there's a little ongoing challenge for the whisky producers. So there you have it. Ralphie's review of Pig's Nose and Sheep Dip. If you see it, don't overlook it. Neither of them are that expensive that you feel you've wasted your money. No way. Particularly, even if you're a single malt connoisseur, to have a bottle of this just for a more relaxed evening when you're not wanting to bombard your taste buds with anything too heavy, they're ideal for that. So there you have it. I'm Ralphie with another Ralphie review of a couple of whiskies in miniature bottles, by the way. Fantastic. I mean, this is a great, if you've got a friend who's a whiskey drinker and you don't want to spend too much money on them, rather than getting them a full bottle of something standard, how about getting them a miniature bottle of something they haven't tried, or something that they maybe wouldn't even consider, or something even a little bit older and rarer and hard to find. And also bear in mind, with when it comes to miniature bottles, they're so much easier to post and send across the different interstate boundaries and across countries, because miniatures don't look quite so bottle-ish, do they? Well, there you have it. I'm Ralphie. Thanks for watching. See you soon for Whisky Review 238. Excellent.